Welcome back viewers. In the last video we have seen the installation of Ultramarine Pantheon Desktop. So let us do the review of the Pantheon Desktop. So before we proceed with the review of the actual desktop, let us check out the website. So we will check out the background of Ultramarine Linux, how it works, what are the advantages, what are the features of Ultramarine Linux. So according to the website, it just works. So it is a Fedora based Linux distribution designed to stay away out of your way and be easy to use. All editions come with different tweaks pre-applied to make the initial setup and daily usage seamless. So many new users might get confused with the Fedora, because Fedora has the latest technologies. They will not have the know-how how to do the different configurations and etc. So they will be overwhelmed by the techiness of Fedora. So Ultramarine Linux tries to address this situation. So it is based on Fedora. It is designed to be 100% bug by bug compatible with Fedora. So the Ultramarine developers have not modded the system too much, so it becomes too much different from Fedora. And then there are both Ultramarine specific bugs and Fedora specific bugs that have to be handled to make the system stable. So it becomes a double work for the developers to maintain their distro as well as the distro on which it is based on. So it is a double work for the developers of the Linux distro derivative. So the right amount of modding has been done by the developers of Ultramarine Linux. So Ultramarine Linux offers the latest and the greatest in the open source software, yet maintaining a rock solid stability. Making sure that things don't break is our top priority. So this is a very good assurance for the users that it is the Linux distro based on Fedora offering the latest and greatest in open source software. So whatever new kernels, new software packages comes in Fedora, it will be available in Ultramarine also. And the rock solid stability of Fedora will be also available in the Ultramarine Linux. Now it is developer friendly. So Ultramarine Linux provides a developer friendly for the average user also tools to make it sure that you can get the most out of your system. And we are making it as easy and accessible as possible for everyone to create and package their software for the Ultramarine. So it is developer friendly and in extension Fedora. So if you develop a package for Ultramarine, then the same package will also run on Fedora. So that is a double advantage of doing your development work on Ultramarine Linux. And third greatest advantage is the same default. So Ultramarine Linux applies common tweaks and settings to make sure that your out of the box experience is as smooth as it can be. We also try to make sure that you will be able to get started as quickly as possible. So what happens is, after you install the Fedora Linux, there are some tweaks that are needed to be done to the system, like adding of the copper repository, adding some other repositories like FlatHub. So here in Ultramarine Linux, that has already been added. So you might require to add some media codecs and everything. So all those things have already been taken care of the developer. So you can just start working and get productive as soon as you install your system. Now let us check out the installation guide. So here in this installation guide is how to get started, how to download. So there are the different editions available, like the flagship edition, the GNOME edition, Pantheon and Qtfish edition, and the Ultramarine Lapis. So the flagship edition is the Budgie desktop that we already checked, I think, in the last video on Ultramarine Linux. So you can check it out in the Ultramarine Linux playlist. And now The second topic is how to check the integrity of the ISO image. So everything is given here. You have to just copy paste these commands and check the integrity of the ISO image you have downloaded by yourself. And how to create the bootable media, that is also given. So it is using the Fedora Media Writer to write the ISO image you have downloaded to a USB. Or you can use Balena HR also, that is an option. Or if you are on a Windows system and want to migrate to Linux, or you want to write the image on a Windows desktop, you can use this. So you can use Rufus. Rufus is also a good writer for different kinds of ISOs. And after that, how to boot into the Ultramarine Linux. So what are the BIOS settings you need to do, how to enter into the BIOS, and everything, all those things are given here. So this is a very nice guide. You should always follow it. It is definitely recommended from my side. Next chapter is the installation. So here you can access this guide on a separate machine. So what you do is, when you're installing on a say your laptop, you put another system besides you, like another laptop, tablet, or a desktop, where this installation guide is open and you can read through it and you can just follow the installation guide. So what is the Anaconda installer? So Anaconda installer, the brief is given about the Anaconda installer. What is the Anaconda hub and spoke model? That is also given. What are the different keyboard layouts, how to add the keyboard layouts, everything is given. How to set the date and time in Anaconda installer, how to do the partitioning and storage management, that is also given. How to do the advanced partitioning, that is also given. And in my installation video, of course, you have seen how to manually partition the hard disk. So everything is there at your disposal. You can check this and you can check my installation video. You will get a good idea. Now there is a mention of the networking. So how to configure your hostname and network settings, how to configure the user accounts, everything is given. So there is nothing that you might miss and botch up your installation. Now this is the post installation part. So after post installation, what you have to do? For example, if you have got the NVIDIA cards, how to install the NVIDIA cards. So that is also given. The commands are given. It is very easy for you. You have to just copy the commands in the clipboard and then you can just paste it. If you are using a virtual machine, so you can directly paste in the terminal of your virtual machine. If you are doing an installation, you can just copy this. You can read this and then type the same command on your system where the Ultramarine Linux has been installed. So for the Optimus laptops, how to use the NVIDIA GPU. So that is given. So this is very excellent installation guide. How to install the codecs, how to set up the snapper, that is the butterfs snapshots. Everything has been given. Now there is a Linux concept section. In that Linux concept section, the concepts overview is there. So what is Linux? What is GNU in Linux? What is the Linux distribution? So a host of Linux distribution names are given. Then the file system is discussed. So the different file systems, the file system hierarchy, what is the different slash home, slash etc, slash dev, what is that? So what is slash proc? So everything, you all the directories of the Linux have been explained. Now there is a separate section on the home directory, so you can check this out. You can go ahead. Then there is a section on the permissions, so the different permissions available to the user, what is the root user. Then there is software packaging and management system. So what is the system package manager, what are the different system package managers available, how to install the different system package managers, how to do a group install of any software package. So say if you want to do a group install of audio production, if you just execute this command, then the packages in this audio production all will be installed along with their dependencies. What are the different other package managers available in Fedora or in Ultramarine Linux? So Snap, Flatpak, and Steam is also available. Steam is for the games. how to install them. Everything is given, so you have to just follow this. It is excellent guide and highly recommended from my side. Then what is the shell? So different kinds of shells are there. What is the default shell on the Fedora or Ultramarine Linux? Everything is given. How to interact with the shell? What are the different commands? Everything is given. So everything in short things are given. It is not very exhaustive, but everything is given in a quick precise way. So you can just start with the working on your Linux system after the installation is done. Now there is a section on development. So if you want to do development for Ultramarine Linux, you have to follow the instructions given how to get start the development on Ultramarine Linux. What is the Python programming language, setting up Rust, how to develop for the Ultramarine Linux. Our main IDE is Visual Studio Code. What is VS Podium? What is open source distribution of VS Studio Code here? So you can download the open source Visual Studio Code from here, link given here. So everything is there, how to do the UI development. For example, the GNOME guidelines are given here. You can follow them. What are the different build systems like CMake, Mason, GNU Auto Tools, how to make a standard make file. All this, everything is given. How to use the package manager. That is the Ultramarine package manager. So everything is given. Even you can check out the build system. It is Koji from Fedora wiki that is used here. So you can check out everything. The different configurations for the package manager, those are also given. How to download a package, how to make a new package, how to build the package, what is the build script. The build script is also given here. Pushing and adding packages to Koji. So everything is there. Then finally the UX guidelines are there. So there are certain guidelines on the UX. So when different developers will develop different packages, they might choose the different path for the UX, and that it will create a very hodgepodge and uneven looking UI or the UX. So to make the packages look similar, there is a UX guideline given. So every Linux distro has some UX guideline, and the developers need to follow it. Then only their packages are accepted in the build system and they are tested. So you must go through this Ultramarine wiki and the installation guide. So it is very helpful for the new users and developers who want to work for the Ultramarine Linux and make packages for Ultramarine Linux as well as Fedora. So now let us now go to the actual desktop. So I already got the GNOME boxes working. So let us start the virtual machine. Okay, so now we are booted into the login screen of Ultramarine Linux. So at the top center, the time and date is given. At the top right, the network manager is there. It is a simple network manager. Just toggle on off for the wired networks. Then there is a power manager. So only two modes are there, suspend and shutdown. In the middle, there is this login screen. At the there is the name of the user, and I think there is a session chooser. So by default, the GNOME on Wayland and GNOME on XORG is available, as well as the Pantheon desktop is available. So you will ask me how the GNOME is installed. We had not chosen the GNOME. Of course, we had not chosen the GNOME, but Pantheon is based on GNOME technologies, and GNOME is the default desktop for the Fedora. So GNOME and Pantheon both are installed, because I think the developers have used the Fedora workstation ISO as the base ISO for this Pantheon desktop. So that's why the GNOME desktop as well as the Pantheon desktops are both available. So now you have to just input your password and you will be logged into the Pantheon desktop. So look how beautiful it is, neat, clean. And you can see the whole wallpaper looks very live, as if you are looking through some camera shutter at the mountains shown on the wallpaper. So the best view of any wallpaper is in Pantheon desktop. I can tell you no other desktop will come close, except I think the Mate desktop of Solus. It is also looking very, very gorgeous. If you use the right kind of wallpapers, the Mate desktop of Solus also looks very good. So this is one of the best desktops. It is very neat and clean. If you use the elementary OS, then elementary OS has many disadvantages, like not many softwares are there available. Of course, you can do install the Flatpak and everything, but that it takes time. But here in Ultramarine, everything, all the required tweaks have been already done by the developers. So the users don't have to waste their time in doing the tweaks for the system to make it more accessible, and more softwares can be installed. So everything has been already done by the installer. So now let us begin. So at the bottom in the dock, you have got the Firefox, the calendar is there, music, videos, and I think the photo viewer is there. In the middle, you got the top middle, you got the calendar, date and time settings are there, and so I think some notifications area is there. Here at the top left, there is the app center, the Blivet GUI is there, the calculator, calendar, camera app is there, code editor is there, color profile viewer, disk, document viewer, evice document viewer, the file manager is there, Firefox, firewall, and the I think this is the LibreOffice suite is there. So all this, many of this software, I think half of the softwares are not installed by default in elementary Linux. So this Pantheon desktop of Ultramarine Linux is better than the elementary OS. So if you like to have lot of the default applications already installed, the useful applications installed, then you should go after the Pantheon desktop of Ultramarine instead of the elementary OS. And of course, if you find the minimal approach of elementary OS okay, then you can install the elementary OS and use it. So it is a matter of choice. So I will show you both choice which are available. Later on, we will do the review and installation of elementary OS also 6.1. So you will have to wait for that, because after this video, I will go back again to the Endeavor OS. So I think three desktops are pending, that is Budgie, Cinnamon is there, and Mate. So we will cover those three desktops from the Endeavor OS. So after that, we have already covered lot of desktops in Arco Linux and Endeavor OS. So we will continue. We will cover all the major desktops of the major Linux distros in this year, in 2022, and later on we will try out the newer Linux distros that are available in the market or will be available in the market in future. So now let us go ahead. At the top right, you have got the audio controls. So the simple audio control, that is the volume slider, and the music player control is available. If you want to do some detailed settings of the sound, then you have to click here, that is the sound settings. It will open up the settings menu, and here you can do the settings of the input and output of the sound card. Then you can configure the event alerts, the screen reader, everything. We will check this out later in when we do the checking of the settings menu. Then there is this simple network manager. If you want to do some extra network setting, detailed network settings, you have to click here on the network settings. It will open the settings manager. Then there is a DND mode. So you just one toggle, do not disturb, or you can disturb. So both, there is only a sliding toggle is there. And at the top rightmost part, you have got the user, that is the user and the user account settings. Then you can lock the desktop, you can log out of the desktop, you can suspend the session, and you can shut down the session. So this is very simple but very useful. Everything that is required by the user at his fingertips is available here. Now let us check out the different applications. So let's first check out the App Center. So this is the elementary OS App Center. So there are some categories available, like the accessories, audio, development, communication, education, finance, games, graphics is there, maths, science and engineering, internet, media production, privacy, security, universal access, video, system, office, engineering. Then there is some writing and language, and the universal access, and of course this one, that is privacy and security. So let us check out the categories. Now the best part of the Ultramarine Linux is that you get all the software that is available in the Fedora repositories here. So in elementary OS, the App Center is does not have that much variety of software, but here loads of software is available. So if you just click on accessories, so you can see here there is huge number of software packages available. I will just call down, I will not speak the names, you can check it out from check it out in your own way when you do the installation of Ultramarine Linux on your system. But it is highly recommended. I like this Ultramarine Linux very much. Just like I like the Arco Linux, this is my new passion, that is Ultramarine Linux. You can see here everything is there, whatever you need is there. These are all accessories, different things are available. Okay, so Plank dock is there, everything is there. You just think of it, I think it will be there, because Fedora repositories are also very huge, just like Debian. So the Red Hat software packages are available in Fedora, and through Fedora it is available in the Ultramarine Linux. And the okay, so I think 38 updates are available. Let us check out the updates, what is available. Okay, so here the operating system updates, 388 components are available. The Seahorse, okay, GStreamer Multimedia Codecs, Nimbus Mono, English, Evice, English Ultra Terminal, Calendars, LibreOffice Writer, okay, system. Some fonts are there, Typing Booster is there. Photos. So this is GStreamer Multimedia Codecs Extra. So you can see here everything has already been installed, even update is also available. So you can see the Intel Media Driver for WAPI, that is the hardware encoder. Hardware video decode is also available, support. So you can see the advantages of using the Ultramarine Linux Pantheon desktop over the elementary OS Pantheon desktop. Okay, now let us go back. So we were checking out the accessories section of the App Center. Now we will close this. We will go again back to App Center. Okay, it is again checking for the updates. This is little curious. Now Signal Desktop is also there, Workbench is there, Learn and Prototype with GNOME Technologies, G4 Music is there, Grape Juice is there. You can see everything is now. Let us check out the audio section. So you can see here the Adobe Flash, Flashware is also available, Amarok, Amberall, all different kinds of audio players and audio software. So here this is a digital audio workstation, Ardor, Audacity is there, Bitrix Studio is there, everything is there, all your audio requirements will be met here. I will just scroll down, you can watch it for yourself. It is really beautiful. I can see that it's the desktop looks so neat and clean. The app center is also neat and clean. In one glance, you can at least check out, say, you can say this 366. 18, 18 and 6, 24 softwares can be checked out in just one glance of the screen. So that is the beauty of the design of the App Center. Everything is there here. Now let us go back to home. Now let us check out the communication section. You see the Slack is there. Zoom is there, WhatsApp is there, ZapZap is there, Teams is there, Teams for Linux, everything, all your requirements will be met. Now let us check out the development section. It is taking some time. The Qt creator, Qt designer, Q terminal, Qt linguist, Qt OD bus viewer. So whole Qt desktop environment is there, development environment is there. Different studios, different IDEs are available. Some programming languages are there like Scratch. R programming IDE is there. Then education software is there. This is specially useful for the users who are in school or in college. Okay, now the finance software. So the Bitcoin software is there. Electron Bitcoin client is there. Electrum GRS, that is the Grostal coin client. It is very thumb twisting, not thumb, sorry, tongue twisting name. Grostal coin client. Okay, here coin. So different wallets are there. Currency managers are there, digital currency managers are there. So there is quite number of software available for the finance section. Now the game section, which will be interesting for most of the users. I think Steam also will be there because Steam is available in Fedora in the software repositories. You can directly toggle the Steam on and the Steam will be installed. So many software, game software is available. DOSBox is available. Leon Linux will be also available. The GeForce Now Electron application is there. I think this is the application to control your Nvidia cards, Nvidia GeForce cards. Very long list of different gaming titles. Now the Steam is there. I said Steam is there. Steam link is there. This is the Torx, the open racing car simulator. This is very old. I have seen the Torx. I have played the, I think, Torx car simulator way back in 10, 15 years back. Okay, so I think now we are done with. Okay, so the graphic section is still pending. Let us check out the graphic section. So these are the graphics applications. LibreCAD is there. It is a 2D computer aided design. Then LibreOffice Draw is there. I wanted to check out one software, whether it is available or not. I will check out. Dust 3D, the quick 3D modeling tool is there. Okay. It is not there, what I was searching. I will cover up that in one of separate video. You can just check out the software. I will scroll down. Okay, now still some categories pending. Let us check out the media production. That will be interesting. I will quickly scroll down because we don't have that much time, otherwise the video will become very long. Okay, not many software here. Then let us check out internet section. So I think all the software that is available in Fedora is there. I don't see any missing software. So different browsers, email clients, messengers, network managers, then your remote desktop clients, everything is there. Then your FTP clients, servers, everything is given here. Feed readers, atomic feed reader, different browsers are there. Download managers, all you think of, all the popular software is there. Microsoft Teams is also available. And in other section, we have seen the Linux Teams also. So Teams for Linux also is there, and Microsoft Teams official package is also there. So you got everything. The RSS guard is also there, feed reader, Rocket Chat is there. I will mention a few. Signal Desktop is there, Skype is there, Steam is also given here. Synology Assistant, it is the Synology NAS, so that is also there. The Synology Drive software is there. So here you can see the Teams for Linux. This is unofficial Microsoft Teams, and at the top you have seen the official Microsoft Teams. So both official and unofficial packages for the Teams software is there. Telegram desktop is there. Everything is there. You think of that, that is available here. Okay, Zoom is there. WebTorrent is there. WhatsApp desktop is there. Now let us check out the maths and engineering, science and engineering section. It is taking little time to open because this is first time it is opening up. So it will sync in the background and then fetch the softwares available. So different math, science and engineering related softwares are there. So different office softwares are there, like the word processors, then the to-do list, agendas, then the office suites are there, ebook readers are there, ebook management software is there. Data boxes is there. Desktop client for the Proton mail. The email clients are also given here for your official needs. LaTeX tools are there. Home bank is there. carbon scalable graphics is there. So calendars, different calendars are there, markets are there. You can keep a tab on your stocks using the markets. Lynx, the document processor is there. LibreOffice suites, Calligra suite, all the different suites are there. Different journals are there. Project management software called Plan is there. So you can manage your office projects from the Plan software. The personal planners are there. Everything is there. It is a very vast repository of Fedora that is available in Ultramarine Linux. Then there is tools for the privacy and security of the users. The firewalls are there, encryption tools, password managers. You can upload the suspected virus files to the virus total uploader. Master key, that is the password manager, is there. Firewalls are there. Seahorse is there. Zap is there. Zenmap is there. KeyPass XE is there. KWallet manager is there. So different privacy and security apps are there. Now let us go to the system section. Here the different system tools will be available to manage your system. So this KDE Discover Software Center is there, DPIM System Monitor, Disk Usage Analyzer, CPUX is the your system profiler. Then there is GNOME boxes, Bionic Manager, BleachBit is there, BleeWed GUI is there, DNF Dragora is there, that is the front end for the DNF using libUI, UI extraction, Dolphin file managers, firewalls are there, Fedora Media Writer, files, GSmart control to monitor your hard disk health. Gparted partition editor, indicator for the KDE Connect, ISO image writer, modem manager is there, multi writer is there, Mate terminal is there, LSHW is there. So you can use this to provide information on your hardware. Logs software is there, local package factory is there. Qwine 4 is there. I think the play on Linux should also be there. SC Linux troubleshooter is there. RISC-V CPU simulator is there. Satellite software to check your GPS connection and save your tracks is there. Virtual machine manager is there. So different system softwares are there. Now let us check out the universal access. I'm specially doing this so you can get an idea of the Ultra Linux software packages. So different users have different expectations of software depending on their requirements. So you will get an idea whether this Ultramarine Linux is good for you or not. I will not cover everything in all the different reviews. So I do the different reviews differently. So every facet of the Linux distro is available to you for your review. So you can make personal choices based on that. So in earlier installation and review video of the Ultramarine flagship desktop, that was Budgie, I had not covered this much in detail, the software part. But now in this video, I thought I would do it. So you will get an idea of how much powerful the Ultramarine Linux is there. Now let us cover the video section. So here the different video players, the video format converters and everything, all those kind of software will be there. It's taking some time. Okay, so you can check out here the different video editing studios will be there, video player, Jitsi Meet, Kodi Entertainment Center, Handbrake is there, which is a video transcoder, Payroll Media Player, MPV Media Player, Shortcut Video Editor, Tube Feeder is there, Video Cutter is there, Videos software is there, VLC Player is there. So different players and editors are available. Now the final, that is the writing and language. I think here you will have the different software for writing, then different language packs, then some font selector, fonts will be available. Let it open. It will take some time to open up. Yes, so different word processors are there, pronunciation trainers like Articulate. You can study Bible, you can check out the different word processors. Text editors are available different. You can check out the code editors. Gedit is there, Ghostwriter is there, Gini is there, Gnome Dictionary is there, GNU Emacs is there, it is extensible text editor. Golden Dictionary is there, it is a dictionary lookup program. So what happens is when you search for any word in the Golden Dict, it will the software will then search for that word that you have typed in the search field and then bring the meaning of that word from the different dictionaries available online. So it does give you a variety of search results, so you can decide upon yourself. Kate is there, that is advanced text editor. Knotes is there, Kwrite is there, Localize is there, it is a computer aided translation system. LibreOffice Suite is there. Lynx is there, that is the document processor. Manuscript is there, it is open source tool for writers. So it is very rich software ability is there in Ultramarine because of the Fedora repos. Only Office desktop editors are there. Text editor, Textworks is there, Visual Studio Code is there, XML copy editor is there. Now let us go back. I think we have completed the software sections, software sections in the App Center of Pantheon Desktop. So now I will close this. Now what we will do is let us check out the settings section and the wallpapers. So wallpapers are interesting for everybody, and the Linux distros with the most beautiful wallpapers are most likely to be selected by users. So it wallpapers do influence the choice by the users. I think there is some update or something is going on in the background. I think the softwares are getting downloaded, updates are getting downloaded in the background automatically. That's why the system is become very slow. Now it is working. Okay, so what I will do is let us check out I think the system monitor. We will get an idea. So this system monitor is nothing but the GNOME system monitor. So let us check out the highest CPU usage. It is that elementary App Center. It is using 24.5 around percentage of CPU usage. Then there is GNOME system monitor, which is the second highest CPU user, and the maximum memory is used by, what is this, Gala? I don't know what is Gala. Okay, that is using the maximum memory. It's Gala. Now let us check out the CPU usage. So CPU usage is swinging between 5 to, we can say, 5 to 13%, we can say. And memory usage is around 2.4 GB. So 2.4 GB is on the higher side as compared to the GNOME desktop. But if you have got a good amount of RAM, like 8 GB of RAM or more than 8 GB, it will be not very straining on your system. There is zero swap usage, and network is also right now not downloading anything or uploading anything. I can say this is little heavy, but it is snappy, except the part when the app center was open. I think the app center was downloading something in the background. Most probably the updates are getting automatically downloaded. Other than that, the system is now snappy. The app center is closed, but now system is okay. It is quite snappy. I don't have any complaints. You can see immediately I get a response. If I click on this cross button, it will immediately shut down the system monitor. So it is there. It is shutting down almost immediately. Okay, so this is the multitasking or the workspace view. So I think there are two, yes, there are two desktops or two workspaces there. Okay. This parental control feature is very good. So if your laptop or your system is being used by your kids also, you can do some settings, user settings, so the kids don't access what is prohibited for their age. So any programs, any software or any web page that is not recommended for the kids, it won't be open. So you can do the parental settings on here. You can also close access to certain folders, important folders like your office folders or say anything that is there inside that is not recommended to be seen by the youngsters. So that will be barred from the youngsters. Now let us go ahead. So the LibreOffice Impress, Math, and LibreOffice Writer is there. It is, I think, not no full complete LibreOffice suite is there. Color Profile Viewer is there, camera is there, calculator is there, and the firewall is there. Let us check out the firewall. Okay, so this is the firewall D. It comes with the zone. So there are specified zones, and the system is configured. The applications are configured zone wise. I already covered this in one of the security videos. I have done some videos on the security of the Linux. I covered this during that time. But that time my channel was very new. Not many people chose to watch my security videos. Then I stopped doing some security videos. But now, since now my channel has matured and there are many users who regularly watch my channel, many subscribers are there. So now I can do such videos on security and other Linux knowledge, advanced knowledge. So people will surely watch now. So I will planning, I'm doing to do such videos in the near future. I will close this down. Have you seen one thing? Just I will show you again. In elementary OS, the closing button to close the window is on the opposite side, that is on the left side, and the minimize button is on the right side. So normally in the other systems, what happens is you got the minimize, maximize, and the close button either on the left or the right side, but here it is different. So the close button is here and the minimize, maximize button is here. What is this? Okay, this button is not working, so there is a bug here. So in my reviews you can see I am always finding bugs. I think in one of the distros I found one bug. It is there in on the record in the video. The bug has been found. And in Spiral Linux, when I was debuting the Spiral Linux for first time, my channel was the first to review the Spiral Linux. So that time also I found a big bug in the installer. So that has been reported. It is for the EFI partition. So if you do a EFI partition less than 500 MB, then the installation of the Spiral Linux fails. So that bug has been taken care of the by the developer. I contacted the developer and then I reported it on the Bugzilla of Spiral Linux, and it was taken care of next day. So now I think we have checked out everything. So this is the Photos app, the screenshot app is there. If you want to see, I will show you the screen. Screenshot app is like this. So first option that is default is screenshot of the whole screen. Then you can take a screenshot of the current window. Then you can select the area to grab the screenshot. You can show the grab pointer. You can close after saving. You can conceal the text. You can have a delay in the snap. So if you put 5 minutes delay, then the snap will be taken after 5 minutes when you click on the take screenshot button. So like this it is. There is terminal also, then there is screenshot. Okay, we already taken. So this is also one other, I think this was same screenshot. Okay, so there are two screenshot programs. So this is the another screenshot program. So here the way to do things is different. So there are screen, window and selection, and then show pointer or not, and then the delay in seconds. So this is also another implementation of screenshot. Sound recorder is there. Music player is there. Let us check out the music player. So that's it. This is the music player. I will not go in too much details. Okay, so it is again showing the 38 updates are available for your system. Now let us check out the system settings. Now this is the only thing that is remaining pending. So here you can set the default applications, the startup applications, the permissions to the different applications. This is all elementary style doing things. So reset, it is not working. I think we'll have to check why it is not working, or maybe yes, because now the permissions and everything to this is managed by the Fedora system, not the elementary. So the base Fedora system is managing all this permissions. So it is grayed out here. And in startup, okay, we can add, I think the applications different. So let us add the applications here. So we can add one program. Let us add something. Yes, we can add the we can add the firewall. That will be good. Okay. So email client is grayed out because there is no email client installed by default. Okay. Now this is the desktop. Okay, so the different, yes, now the wallpapers, yes, different wallpapers are available. Let us try this out. This looks good. Can try this out. This is also good. So traditionally elementary comes with very 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 beautiful wallpapers. If you are a wallpaper lover and you like neat and clean desktop, you stay with elementary. Nothing, no desktop like the elementary Pantheon desktop. Wallpapers are very great. This is the one I like very much. It is very soothing for the soul when you see this wallpaper in the evening. This one is also great looking. So here you see the, I think this is the spaceship or some satellite. It is spaceship, yes, it is a spaceship. So it looks very good. This one is also nice looking. Okay, so I think now we check out the preference. So default is the light theme. We will go and change over to dark theme. And the schedule to shift from the light to dark theme is also given. So we will choose the automatic sunset to sunrise. So again, the style becomes default, that is lights theme. Ascent is blue ascent. We can go with, maybe we can go with this orange ascent. This is suit the orange looking flowers. Here the text size is there. We can increase the text size or we can decrease the text size. And the dyslexia friendly. So bottom heavy shapes and increased character spacing can improve the legibility and reading speed of the dyslexia suffering persons. And now the dock and panel. So right now the icon size is medium, I think. So you'll have to watch the dock at the bottom. You can change it over to and make it big. You can make it very small also. I will prefer the middle size. You can hide the dock when any window overlaps it. You can have the pressure reveal. So if you click, so here you can see the pressure is shown. Okay, now in the panel translucency. Okay, so any changes there? Okay, the top panel. Okay. So now the panel is not translucent, and if you toggle it on, the panel becomes translucent. Multitasking, you can have the hot corners and select the action taken or at the hot corners from here. Okay. Now let us check out the system. So Ultramarine Linux 36 based on Fedora Linux 36 is there. There is no mention of the, okay. So the firmware updates, if available, will be shown here and then you can install it. So there is no mention of the Pantheon desktop version, only the Ultramarine Linux version 36, Fedora version 36 and the Linux kernel 5.17.7 is there. Now what I will do is I will go back. Now let us check out the tweaks. So here you can do the appearance tweak. So the different theme settings, you can install the different theme settings. There are some themes already installed. So this is the beauty of Ultramarine. So you don't have to install anything. Many of the themes will be already pre-installed. You can just select and start working with the themes that you like. Even the icon themes, two icon themes are there, but GTK themes, multiple have been installed by default. The cursor themes are also there. Sound theme, only two are there, that is Free Desktop and Elementary. Force to use dark style sheet option is there. Windows control layout. So you can, here right now it is the Windows control layout, but you can change over to Elementary, Ubuntu, Mac OS, Elementary, reverse, different window controls are there. So thus buttons at the window like this, close button, minimize, maximize buttons will change position and depending on the window control you are selected. Now let us check out the fonts. So the Open Sans family is used and only in the title bar the Cantarel bold, that is the default font family Cantarel used in Fedora. So this is the animation close and open times, sound indicator, maximum volume is 100, you can increase it beyond 100 also. So files, restore the tabs, date format is informal, local or ISO, and the terminal, you can choose the terminal background color, follow last tab, unset paste alert, remember tabs, terminal bell, always show tabs, never or hide when single tab. So different options are there. Test, there are controls for the keyboard, mouse, touchpad, printers, sound. Let us check out the displays. So you can toggle the night light, set it to sunrise to sunset, or you can do it manual also. And you can set the color temperature slider. This is the network manager. So you can control your wired connections, wireless connections, VPN and proxy from here. You can connect your online accounts, for example, IMAP, that is your email client, Caldev, that is the calendar and task from your email. Here, go back, universal access, let us check out, nothing is coming up in universal access. It should come here, the accessibility, but it is not coming up anywhere. Okay, sharing, let us check out the sharing section. Okay, so you can share the media library from here. You can share your music, videos, photos, or all the three from here. You can toggle them on off. Back. This is the Bluetooth manager here. So the typical Bluetooth manager settings will be available here. Right now there is no Bluetooth available, so it is not showing anything. Let us check out the mouse. These are the mouse and touchpad settings. So you can adjust the mouse sensitivity, clicking, tapping, scrolling method, natural scrolling or artificial scrolling, ignore while typing, when mouse is connected, the behavior of the mouse and touchpad, everything you can do it from here. Now anything is pending, okay, the notifications. So here you can set the different notifications setting for each of your application available or installed on your system. And you can do a custom notification setting for each of your app from here. And you can also do a system wide DND from the toggle given here. Okay, I think we have covered everything. So I will close the system settings now. Maybe I think we should check out the version of Pantheon Desktop given. So where it will be visible. Let us check out. No, it is not available here. We can check it out, I think, in the App Center. Okay, let us check out the version. Nowhere it is given, I think. Where is the Pantheon Desktop version? Yes, maybe in calendar. Some of the app it will be mentioned. Photo Viewer, let us check out. At least one of the apps should give us the version. This is also not giving. How to check them? Okay. Most probably it will be elementary OS Pantheon Desktop version 6. So the Pantheon Desktop coming with the elementary OS 6 is this, but I am not getting a confirmation anywhere. How to search for that? Not a single software is showing it. MNI Center. So this is the GDIS from the GNOME desktop. Maybe it will show. About disk. So GNOME disk utility 42. So most probably this is the Pantheon desktop found in elementary OS 6. So this is the latest, not we can say latest, very latest 6.1, but from the elementary OS version 6 only, not 6.1. Or what we can do is, let us check out the software updates. If the elementary OS packages have some updates, we can check it from there. Just wait for that to open up. Okay. Any software package for the elementary, we will know the version. The elementary OS. Most of these packages belong to. Okay, so this music app is version 5.1.1. You can see here. So I'm sorry, I think it is not that much updated also, but still it will be, I think, elementary OS 6 only or 5.1. To be worse, it will be 5.1. Let me check out. So these are the Fedora updates. You can see here, all this is Fedora only. So all this is Fedora. Yes, most of these packages, 99% is Fedora only. So from the music version app, I can say you, this is elementary OS 6 Pantheon desktop that is given here. It will be not more updated than that. Only you can say Pantheon desktop available that is in elementary OS 6. So that's it for today. I will close the video here. It was one of the most interesting reviews I have done. Most beautiful and most clean looking desktop that we have used. So you are now aware of the power of Ultramarine Linux, the features and advantages over the elementary OS Pantheon desktop. So you can always install this. You will get the goodies of Fedora with the goodness of elementary OS desktop, that is Pantheon desktop. So both have been combined here in Ultramarine Linux. So see you in the next video. Bye bye.